Yes.
I nearly didn't make it then, only just in time. You have to be so careful when the clock begins to chime. Well, goodness me, what do I see? Lots of girls and boys. I suppose I should have guessed enough when I heard all that noise. Well, thank you all for coming and being with us today. I promise you all a fairy tale before you go away. Like all good fairies, as you will see, I'm very good at spelling. There's only one thing I like more, and that is storytelling. For you see, it's so useful when you have to speak and rhyme to know that you can always start with once upon a time. A child was born, a pretty girl, her heart so sweet and true. Everybody loves Cinderella, and I'm sure that you will too. Although she was an only child, no sister and no brother, she did have one advantage, me. Her fairy godmother. Then one sad day, her mother died. Poor Cinderella, she cried and cried. And as she watched her father grieve, Cinderella swore she'd never leave. But it wasn't an easy life, you see, for they weren't as rich as they used to be. Anyway, for the moment, that's all you need to know. So to the village of much idling, we now shall go.
It's a hard knock life for us. It's a hard knock life for us. Steady live, we get tricks. Steady kisses, we get kicks. It's a hard knock life. Got no folks to sleep or so. It's a hard knock road we hoe. Warm blankets instead of warm empty bellies. It's a hard knock life. Don't it feel like the wind is always howling? Don't it seem like there's never any noise? What's the day, don't you want a brother tell me? It's easy how to put it up on fights. No one's there when you kiss like a creepy. No one cares if you grow or if you shrink. No one tries when your eyes get red and weepy. Revolves crying and the wind is going to sing. Any life, not a spreading life, not a sore life, not a more life.
Santa Claus we never see. Santa Claus, what's that? Who's he? No one cares for you.
A smidge when you're in a town like this. It's a hard knock life.
Cinderella.
I love winter days like this. It may be cold and frosty, but when the sun shines, it makes everything sparkle like diamonds.
Oh, yes, right.
Oh, I'm so glad it's a beautiful morning because my father's coming home today. He's only been away for a month and I have missed him so much.
Well, it's Baron Hard Up been, Cinder.
He's been to see his brother, Lord Moneybags.
He's back! His brother is Lord Moneybags.
Yes, his older brother.
Oh.
The one who inherited the family fortune.
Your father's always broke.
Yeah, I mean,
He's nearly as poor as us.
Oh, well, we may not have much money, but we always have each other. And if we ever feel down, then we have buttons to cheer us
up.
Speaking of buttons, actually, that's who I came looking for, but I can't seem to find him anywhere. Will you help me find him?
Yes, of course.
And well, you will help me too. Excellent. All together. One, two, three.
Buttons!
Hey kids! Oh come on, get ready! My name's Buttons. When I shout hiya kids, I want you to shout hiya Buttons. You got it? Shall we have a go?
Yeah.
Right, hiya kids!
Hiya!
Still can't hear ya. Shall we try again? Hiya kids!
Hiya!
Oh, that's great. I work at Hard Up Hall, you know, for Baron Hard Up. And he's coming home today, so I've been doing a bit of shopping. And I've got all this. You'll never guess what it is. What do you think this is? It's a box. And what do you think this is? It's a matchbox. Right, tell you, I've got another one here. What do you think this is? It's a pill box. Oh, and what do you think this one is? It's a pillow box, correct, right. Oh, I've got another one here. This is an easy one. What do you think this one is? It's a letter box, of course, isn't it? It's obvious. But I've got the main one here. What do you think this is in here? It is indeed a big box of Harry Bows, and you shall have some. One there. One there.
One there.
Well, I bought so much stuff they gave me a free gift book. It's nursery rhymes for today. There's some good nursery rhymes in here. Shall I tell you some? Well, I'm going to do it anyway. Right. Humpty Dumpty sat on the wall. Humpty Dumpty had a great fall. The structure of the wall was incorrect, so he won a grand on claims don't rent. Yeah, I thought it was funny. Jack and Jill went to town to buy some chips and sweeties. Now he can't keep his heart rate down, and she's got diabetes. One more. And Mary had a little lamb. Her father shot it dead. Now Mary takes her lamb to school between two bits of bread. Well, that's quite enough of that. Shall we see if we can kill a stagehand? Here we go then.
Oh!
Right, have you met Cinderella yet?
Yeah.
You have? Oh, isn't she lovely? I've got a little secret. Well, I've got to tell you, I think I love her. No, I do. I really love her. But you promise not to tell anyone, especially Cinderella, yes? You must never tell her. Cinderella must never know.
I never know, Button.
Oh, that is Friday.
Oh, I know it's Friday, Button.
Oh, I thought it was a secret.
Sometimes you really are strange.
Oh, so are you, Cinder, so are you.
Have you forgotten my father's coming home today?
No, I haven't, and I hope he's managed to borrow some money off his brother, because I haven't been paid any wages for nearly a year.
Oh, well, I'm sure he'll pay you as soon as he's back.
Cinderella, Cinderella.
Oh, that sounds like him now.
Cinderella, my dear, dear girl. How do, Buttons?
How do, Baron?
Ow!
Good to see you.
Where was Father?
Well, I was on the way back to the village and some of the villagers stopped me going back to the hall.
Oh, why?
Well, I was on the way back to the hall because inside is your special surprise.
A special surprise?
Mm. Don't tell me you've come back with a sack of gold or a chest full of treasure.
Ooh.
No, but it is true my brother did... win a fortune, made a fortune in the city.
Oh, insider dealing, eh?
Mm. No, he worked in Starbucks Cafe, but Pret a Manger opened next door and now he's down to his last million.
Oh. Yeah.
So he couldn't lend you any money?
No, but he came up with a splendid idea. He knew of a wealthy widow with two daughters of her own who was looking for a titled husband.
Yes.
I thought it was a brilliant idea. So, without even seeing the woman, I agreed to marry her the very next day.
Oh, good.
So, my dear, that is your special surprise. You have a stepmother.
A stepmother?
Mm, and two stepsisters as well. I hope you're not too upset with me.
Of course I'm not upset. You've looked after me on your own ever since I was a little baby. I think it's wonderful you've married again, and plus, I've got two new sisters. We can be one big happy family.
Oh, I do hope so.
You pulled a bit of a stroke there, Baron. All I can say is, good luck! Oh,
well thanks, done. Spartans. I think we're going to need it.
What do you mean?
Well, all seemed fine at the church the next morning. My new bride-to-be had a shapely enough chassis.
Steady on, pal.
She was wearing a lovely big large hat with a veil, and then... she pulled back the veil and... Well, I was expecting a ray of sunshine.
Yes.
I got a thunderstorm. Yes, my dear.
Henry Harder, I want an explanation.
Concerning what, Hermione?
You sent me by carriage to what you said was Harder Hall. I think you meant it was hardly a hovel.
Well, the house does need a bit of a makeover, I confess.
It's not the only thing.
And then the coachman drove off and left me standing there.
I'm complaining.
And then I knocked on the door and there were no servants around to let me in. What is the meaning of this?
All the servants have got the day off.
Mm. All of them? Mm. How many servants do you have, Henry?
Buttons.
That apology of a human being is your entire staff? Oh, what is this? Something to do with community service?
I look forward to being abused by you, ma'am.
You will be. What about Miss Lockjaw over there? What does she do?
Oh, she's not a servant, Hermione. That's my dear, dear little girl. My Cinderella. I told you all about her.
Oh, but you said she was pretty. You obviously forgot to add the words ill-mannered.
I'm delighted to meet you, stepmother.
So you should be.
I'll be more than happy to make you and my new sisters happy here.
Mm, Cinderella's a very good cook.
Well, I should hope so, Henry. But that won't be all she has to do. My girls are far too elegant and refined to do anything for themselves, so she'll have to be their maid servant too.
I'll be happy to help them.
And of course, you will have to look after me. In fact, you can start by going back up to Hardup Hall and running me a bath.
Oh, I'm sure Buttons could do that for you.
Certainly not, Henry. He may not be much of a man, but he's not coming anywhere near my bathroom. Oh,
that won't be a problem, I promise you.
Where are my new sisters?
Oh, they had far too much luggage to fit onto the carriage, so they're coming by train. In fact, you can go to the station and meet them, Bottoms.
My name is Buttons.
Oh, whatever. Off you go. And you girls, you stand there. Off you go.
Yes, stepmother.
Henry! Heel!
Yes, my dear.
Come along.
Oh, she called me Bottoms. That's a bit cheeky, isn't it? Well, I'm not walking all the way to the station. Cinder's new sisters will have to pass this way. I'm sure they'll be nice, won't they? Oh, they can't be as bad as their mother, can they? Oh, nobody could be as bad as the Baroness, could they? Oh, no, well, just you wait and see. They'll be fine.
I'm
You were right, boys and girls. They are as bad as their mother. Oh, no. Oh, look.
Oh, I say. Oh, sis. Look at this one. What's your name then, Chunky?
I'm Buttons. I'm a handyman.
Oh, that sounds useful. I wonder if a handyman can.
I work at Hard Up Hall.
Really?
Yeah.
That's where we're going to live.
Oh, no.
Lucky boy.
Now, my name is Mona Hard Up, soon to be discovered superstar, but most people call me Moan.
Oh, right. That's because she's always whinging. And I'm the Victoria Beckham lookalike. Griselda Hard Up. But my friends call me Grizzle.
Most people call her Grizzly. Now make yourself useful, Buttons, and call me a cab.
Okay, you're a cab.
Thank you.
No, I mean, get me a taxi.
I can't do that.
Well, why ever not?
I haven't been invented yet.
Oh. Well, if we're going to have to walk there, we need a rest first.
Okay.
So you can take all our luggage.
Oh, right. Here we go then.
And be careful with mine. It's mainly designer label, TK Maxx, Primark, that sort of thing.
Oh, yeah. Just one thing, if I'm doing all this paltering, do you think I'll get a tip?
Oh, yes.
Yeah.
Of course, I'll give you a tip, Button. Come
here. Yeah?
The tip
what
is
a tip?
Don't mess with me.
Ouch! Oh, get that Hard Up Ball. And make sure our baths are drawn.
And our beds are turned down. Oh, and our dinners are on the table.
Okay, your drawers are down, your beds are in the bath, and your dinner's on the table. Yeah, bye! Fair
enough, I suppose.
Here, Mo.
Yes?
When we were coming through all that crowd down
there.
Oh,
yes.
Did you notice a terrible smell?
Oh, I did, but it's easily explained. I mean, you see how many brownies there are out there.
But you like children, don't you,
Mo? No, indeed I do. I adore children. I'm just not sure whether I can eat a whole one.
Poor deprived things. They don't know who we are, do they?
That's because we haven't been introduced. But you know we're the beautiful sisters, don't you? Oh, yes, we are.
Oh, yes, we are.
We are.
Well, I'm the most beautiful one anyway.
Even they are not that stupid. I'm the most beautiful one, aren't I?
No, you're not. You can forget the fellas, Moan.
Really?
Because I'm the one with everything that a man desires.
Oh, no, you're not.
Well, she might be. She's got a beer gut and tattoos.
Why, you?
Look, let's not argue. One day you'll find Mr. Wright.
Moan?
Yes?
I think I already have.
Really?
Yeah. See that man down there?
Well, this one down here.
Yeah, the one that's not looking at me now.
He won't look at you, will he?
Yeah, well, yeah. He keeps winking at me.
No, he's not winking at you. He's got a nervous tic.
Oh.
Don't worry. Even if you never find Mr. Wright, you've always got me.
Oh, that's what makes me feel so depressed.
Sisters, sisters, never such devoted sisters. We never had to have a chaperone, no son. I did keep my eye on her. Caring, sharing, every little thing that we are wearing. Or when a certain gentleman arrived from Rome,
I wore the dress,
and I had a moan. Little boy had on Friday evening, Miss Wickham. What wore the glass? And again, my dear.
Sharing, every little thing that we are wearing. But when a certain gentleman arrived from Rome,
I wore the dress,
And I had a bow. It's that way, dear.
No, it's not that way.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Okay, fair enough. Aren't we adorable?
Oh, get lost.
What horrid girls those sisters are.
As a fairy, I suppose, I really shouldn't say this, but they do get up my nose. Anyway, don't you worry. I'll look after Cinderella, for what she needs to do is to find the right fella. Right now, there's a prince in the forest, so that's where we will go. All I do is wave my wand, and here we are. See you later. Cheerio.
Come along, Your Highness. There's only a couple of miles to go now.
I know, Danzini, I know. Every step of the way, my heart gets heavier.
Why? We've been living abroad for 3 years. I'm looking forward to getting home and seeing all my mates again, ladies. Thanks for coming out.
Well, I never had any friends.
Well, thanks a lot.
Oh, not until you came to work for me, Danzini. I've been brought up in a royal palace with private tutors, and everyone bowing and scraping to me. That's why I went to university in France. Somewhere I wasn't known. Somewhere I could be me.
Well, I'm glad we're back. I never did get on with any of that French food, you know. I'm looking forward to some proper English grub. A pizza. A kebab. Oh, a booner from Curry Corner. Get it.
All I know is now my father's died, I'm going to have taken all the duties of the state. Endless meetings and hundreds of documents to sign.
Oh, we all have our little crosses to bear, sir. Must be very hard on the wrist. Here, be grateful you're not Professor Dumbledore. That is a signature, my friend. I'm telling you.
Oh, I know it's not hard work, Dandini, but it's so boring. Can't you understand? I just want to be free from all of this royal protocol. If just for one day I'd like to be a boring, ordinary person. Someone like, you.
Well, thanks. I had no idea why they call him charming.
Oh, look, I didn't mean it like that. It's just, your life is so much richer than mine.
Can't say I've noticed. I'm always skint. I'd change places with you any day.
That's it. We'll change places for a day. I'll be you, and you can be me. Oh, and then you'll have some sympathy for the problems of a prince.
Oh, yeah, maybe you know what it's like to be a servant.
Oh, I'd like that.
Oh, don't be daft, it'll never work.
Why not?
Well, look, you've got dark hair, so...
Well, you've got dark hair.
Oh, yeah, alright. Well, look, you've got blue eyes, so...
Well, you've got blue eyes.
Oh, alright, well, alright, well, women really fancy you.
Well... Okay, 2 out of 3's not bad. Look, we've been out of the country for ages. No one will know what either of us look like.
Yeah, that's true, I suppose. But, you talk all funny.
What do you mean, all funny?
Well, look, not proper like what I do.
Well, I could talk proper like what you do.
All right, not bad. You know, a little bit Dick Van Dyke, but it's not bad. Thing is, could I talk like you?
Oh, it's easy to talk like a member of the royal family. I'll teach you. You just have to answer 3 simple questions.
All right, go on then, fire away.
Okay, the first question. What do we breathe?
Air.
Oh, very good. And what grows on our head?
Hair.
Oh, yes. And wolves live in a...
A lair?
Yes. Now, all you need to do is put all 3 together.
All right, okay. Air, hello.
Oh. Hello! Hello!
Oh, hello! I get it!
That was wicked! Oh, look, tomorrow in this very forest there's to be a homecoming royal hunt. Just for me. It'll be the perfect opportunity for your royal debut. Your Highness.
Thank you, my good fellow.
Now look, all you need to do is put this on. Oh, you look like the prince already. Come along then, Dandy.
Oh, excuse me, I do believe you are forgetting your place, good fellow.
Oh, I beg your pardon, Your Highness.
Glorious blessed, but listen, I am.
Oh, wait, was I going over the top?
Oh, no, no, it was perfect. You are the prince.
Ooh.
Gonna be a mighty king, swear to me, beware.
Well, I never thought I'd pull it off with air and hair and leg.
Gonna be the main event that no king was before.
It seems a lot to wear the crown, now I'm pretty sure.
Just think of all that the madness will bring. Oh, I just can't wait to be king.
What? After you, Your Highness.
Thank you, good fellow. This way, please. Royalty is coming through midway.
Those naughty boys have changed about. What a thing to do. It's a good job we all heard them, or we wouldn't know who's who. At least we know when next the prince will appear. At the royal hunt. And I'll make sure Cinderella is near. So what I'm going to do is to write Cinder a note. Here's one I prepared earlier, still warm, and this is what I wrote. It may be a little short, but it'll give her the subtlest of hints. A royal hunt in the forest tomorrow. There you'll meet your prince. I'll leave this letter for her so she knows where to go. It's off to the woods for Cinders. That's where she'll meet her beau.
Cinderella! Oh, hi, kids! Have you seen Cinderella? I'm not surprised since Griselda and Mona turned up. We've had so many jobs to do. Oh, what's this? More junk mail. What's it say? A royal hunt in the forest tomorrow. There, you'll meet your prince. Who can this be for? Oh, I wish you wouldn't do that.
What are you up to, Buttons?
I've just found this odd note.
Oh, I've heard you sing, Buttons. You're always finding odd notes.
No, this note. It's about a royal hunt.
Roy Lunt. No, never heard
not
of it.
Not Roy Lunt, a royal hunt. It says my prince will be there.
Oh, that'll be a reminder from Super Snaps.
Not those sort of prints, a royal prince.
Oh, here, let me see. What does it say? Well, I wonder who this note could be for. Certainly can't be for me.
Well, I hope it's not for me either.
Ooh. Who's pretty and bright.
It can't be for them.
How do, Daddy Weddy?
Watch your box, you want me?
Oh, my dear new daughters. Have you had a nice day?
Yeah. I tell you, it's very difficult to keep looking as hot as we do.
Yes, I've totally pooped, so we need our beauty sleep, so we're going to have an early night.
Well, you're going to have a long night in too, then.
Yes.
But before we go to bed, we want to have a bath in asses milk.
Oh, well, do you want it pasteurised?
Oh, no. Only up to here. And we've made a list of chores for Cinderella to do.
Yes, so where is the lazy little lackey?
I think she's down in the cellar.
Probably polishing your Doc Martens, yeah.
Well, don't just stand there, Daddy. Go and get her.
Oh, yes, Griselda. At once, Griselda. Anything you say, Griselda. Three bags full, Griselda.
Oh, I say, Buttons, how are you feeling?
Oh, fine, thanks. I'm feeling really good.
Ooh. Well, we can't have that, can we, Gris?
Oh, that was brilliant.
I enjoyed that.
You wanted me?
Indeed we do.
Yes. You've not been doing enough around the house.
No, so we've made a list of jobs for you to do before you go to bed.
Oh, dear.
So, before tomorrow morning, Cinders, you can scrub all the floors.
Okay.
And polish the doors.
Wash all my socks.
And oil the locks.
Peel the carrots.
Feed the parrots.
Hoover the halls.
And my s'mores.
Clean the windows.
And when you've done that, Cinders, you can bake us a cake.
Oh, and grill us a steak.
Collect lots of tweets.
And muck out the peas.
Sweep the front path.
And clean out my bath.
And beat all the maps.
And neuter the cats.
And fill all the lamps with oil.
And then you could prick my boy.
You'll enjoy doing that.
Oh, dear, well, that's an awful lot of jobs to do. I don't suppose you could help me.
What? Us? Do household duties? Who do you think we are?
No, we couldn't possibly help you, even if we wanted to. Because tomorrow, my sister and I are going to that new beauty parlour down in Hayes.
Yes, the one that promises to make any woman beautiful in 30 minutes.
Oh, dear. How long will you two be away, then?
About 3 days.
Yes.
Well, if you two are both out tomorrow and I've got all of these jobs to do, then I suppose nobody will be going to the royal hunt.
Exactly. What royal hunt?
What are you talking about?
Buttons found this note and then he gave it to Daddy and Daddy gave it to me.
Oh, we don't want to hear its life history. Just tell us what it says.
It says, royal hunt in the forest tomorrow. There you will find your prince.
Griselda!
A prince!
Right. No, you can't.
Daddy, no,
Daddy,
you
can't.
I'll sort you out.
What's going on here?
It's all her fault, Mummy.
She started it, Mummy.
Explain yourself, girl.
They tried to take this note from me.
So why didn't you give it to them?
Because Daddy gave it to me.
I can't believe this. That man spoils you.
The note was all about a royal hunt in the woods tomorrow, Mummy.
Yes, the prince is going to be there, Mummy.
And we want to see him.
Then you shall, my darling.
But what about me?
You? You can't possibly go, Cinderella. You have nothing to wear.
Well, what about this? It's my best dress.
Oh, I think you mean it's my only dress.
What?
Oh, my darling little girls, needed more wardrobe space, so I had your other clothes thrown on the bonfire.
You can't have.
Oh, I did. And it's not important anyway. I mean, look at you. You have terrible dress sense. I mean, this neckline is just all wrong. And these sleeves are terrible. And this sleeve is terrible. And this hemline is dreadful.
Ruined it! How could you?
Oh, stop sniffing, girl! You're looking even uglier with a runny nose. Now, girls, if you're going to the hunt tomorrow, I must go and find your outfits and make sure they're clean. Get out of the way, girl.
What do you mean by that, Moan?
Well, I think she might be insinuating we've got some bad habits. Aren't we adorable? They're not sure, are they?
Get your eyes, Tessie. Yes. Hiya, kids! Hiya, Cinders, what's happened to your frock?
Oh, Buttons, my stepmother ripped it to stop me from going to the royal hunt.
Did you want to go?
Well, no, not really, but it would have been nice to meet Prince Charming.
Why is that?
Because he could look like Prince Harry.
Oh, yes, but he could look like Prince Charles.
Oh, Buttons, you are naughty.
Oh, you're doing it again!
What's going on here, Cinders?
Oh, Buttons was just making me laugh.
Oh, he wasn't taking his clothes off again, was he? I say, what's happened to your dress?
Why don't you ask your new wife?
Oh, dear Buttons, she seems a little upset.
There's no fooling you, is there, Baron?
Oh, well, Hermione does have a bit of temper, I'm afraid.
I'm afraid? You're afraid? The rest of us are terrified. Why did you marry the old boot?
Well, I thought Cinders could do with a new mother, and I certainly knew I could do with some more money.
Oh, you could have sold the family silver.
Oh, I did that years ago.
And what about your medals? You could have sold them.
Oh, not my medals. Oh. No, they mean the world to me. I never take them off.
No?
I wear them on my morning suit, I wear them on my evening suit, and as you see, I wear them on my dressing gown.
Oh, what if you go swimming?
In that case, I pin them on my Speedos.
Oh, could be painful. Do not go skinny dipping.
Oh, no, I won them when I was in the army, you know. Major Henry Harder.
Oh.
I served on the Northwest Frontier.
Did you?
That's why I wear them on the frontier. You get it, on the frontier. That's the way I tell them.
I am getting worried about him, kids.
See you later.
My lords, ladies and gentlemen, pray silence for His Royal Highness, Prince Charming.
A very good morning to all my objects. Subjects.
You really blew it then.
I am terribly pleased to welcome you all to my royal hunt. The but today's hunt shall not mean chasing foxes. It shall be a treasure hunt.
His Highness does not approve of animal cruelty.
Indeed, I agree with that great man, Oscar Angry.
Who? Wild.
Oscar Wilde. That fox hunting is the unspeakable in pursuit of the uneatable. Yes, these are facts.
But it does mean his treasure hunt might be worth a bob or two. You see, this morning, a gold sovereign was hidden in this berry forest.
Gold? Treasure?
Yes, sir. The first person to find it may keep it.
See?
Thanks. All right, I'll do.
Oh, very good, Your Highness. Now, do I have your permission to go?
Oh, where?
Look, there's no point us switching places if I don't go on some adventure.
Well, yeah, that's all fine and good, Your Highness, but if that lot can't find that gold sovereign, there's going to be trouble.
Why won't they find the gold sovereign?
Because I've got it here in my pocket. Oh. All right, look, I never had the chance to hide it.
Look, give it here. We'll hide it over here and someone will come across it, I'm sure.
Yikes!
I'm sorry, we were late. We weren't late. And my horse, he kept playing up. Great down. And Mona here, she had a pain in her posterior.
Oh, I did. Ladies, ladies!
You're a big boy, aren't you?
Lovely hair. I bet you'll wash and go.
So who are you then, hunky?
I'm the prince, the prince's servant.
Servant? How dare you finger our fabulous physiques? You, flippin' flunky!
No, this is his eye.
Really? Then here are hold our horses.
Well, it's hardly king size, is it?
No, but they do say interesting packages come in small packages or something like that.
Yes, and I quite like them, Dinky. So, where's your horse, Your Highness?
My horse?
Well, the ump, of course. You can't ump without an horse.
This is not a fox hunt.
Oh, what a shame. I love killing vermin.
There's all this lot out here for stuff.
This is a treasure hunt. Even now people are searching the forest.
Oh, what fun. It's been ages since I went for a tramp in the woods.
Yes, I remember the last time. How upset you were when you couldn't find it.
Take me, Luke. Oh, she's just jealous of my beauty. So what's the prize then?
The prize is a gold sovereign.
I was talking to the organ grinder, not the monkey.
Yes, but it isn't.
Well, I wish you luck in your search, lady.
We won't need luck, will we, Griselda?
And we're not going to go looking for the treasure. You must know where it is. You could tell us, couldn't you? Chichi?
That would be cheating!
Oh, isn't he quaint as if we care?
Yes.
Yes, I remember too.
Sorry? What is it about? Oh, yes.
Oh, well, yes.
Really. Yes, Princey. I must warn you. My sister and I are like the mountains.
I told you.
Oh, yeah. Big butch and Canadian.
Dare you? No, we always get our man.
So I'd put your hands up if I were you.
Oh, you wouldn't dare!
Try me.
Oh, no!
You people did enough! Oh, you're a big elf, you are!
Oh, it's them being a prince!
Princey!
It's a right royal runner, that one, isn't it?
Oh, his highness is fit!
Told you before. Don't speak until you're spoken to.
Wash your mouth out.
Yeah, forget that servant moan.
Oh, yes.
It's a prince we're after.
Oh, yes, into the woods. Oh, perhaps we could grab it by the chestnuts.
Oh, that'd be useful.
That'd be adorable. Still not sure, are you?
Get your eyes tested.
Yes.
Hello, boys and girls. I've come out to the woods to collect some firewood. I hoped I might see the prince, but no luck yet. Oh, I expect he's really handsome.
Come in, my dear.
Why, of course. Are you all right? You look exhausted.
I've walked such a long way. I'm very tired.
Well, where are you going?
Oh, nowhere in particular. I was out collecting wood for my fire.
Well, you can take these. Keep yourself warm.
No, I couldn't possibly.
Please, I insist.
Well, won't you leave them?
Oh, it's okay. I can easily gather some more. There's some of it here.
What is it, my dear?
A gold coin.
Let me see. Oh, it's a sovereign.
It's the prize in the royal treasure hunt. May I keep it?
Of course, it is yours. You can buy whatever you like with it.
Whatever I like. Oh, a dress. How I love a new dress. So exciting!
Oh, I'm sorry, my dear.
You're not well, are you?
I haven't eaten in days.
Then you're starving. Then here, take the gold and buy yourself some food.
Well, what about your new dress?
Clothes are not important. Please, take it.
Well, thank you, Cinderella. You have a good heart.
I wish you well. Goodbye.
Well, look at the kindness Cinderella displayed. To a poor old woman, she came to my aid. Trust me, I'll always be around. I'll watch her night and day, and I shall keep her safe and sound in every single way. This Cinderella, so loving, so true and sincere. I said one day her prince would come, and now that day is here.
Old lady!
Oh, excuse me!
You startled me.
Oh, I'm sorry. Can I help? You seem a bit upset.
Well, actually, I was talking to an old lady and I gave her my bundle of sticks and then I gave her a gold coin to go and buy herself some food with. And then she just disappeared and, sorry, I'm a little bit confused.
Oh, I haven't seen her, I'm afraid.
Who are you?
I'm Dandini. I work up at the Royal Palace.
The Royal Palace? You must live such an exciting life.
Oh no, I'm just the prince's valet, just a servant.
That's what my stepsisters say I am.
What's that?
Oh, it doesn't matter. I was just thinking out loud. So the Royal Palace. Oh, all those beautiful people in lovely clothes.
Oh, clothes don't make people beautiful.
Oh, don't be silly. How can anyone look beautiful in rags like these?
Oh, I think you look very beautiful.
Islands in the stream, that is what we are. No one in between, how can we be wrong? Sail away with me to another world, and we rely on each other. From one lover to another.
Oh, wait, don't go!
Your Highness! All right, that's it. I've had it. It's done. It's me and the prince. He's been chased by them two all day. Let me be a servant again.
Oh, no, she's gone.
Your Highness, I know some princes talk to trees, yeah? But why are you shouting at them?
Oh, she's just so beautiful. And I didn't even get to know her name.
Who are you talking about?
Oh, Dandini, I've met her.
Met who?
The girl of my dreams.
Oh, well, that's lovely for you, sir. Meanwhile, I've got two nightmares chasing after me.
She's wonderful.
Well, where is she then?
Oh, I don't know. She just disappeared. But I must meet her again.
She can't have gone far. Why don't I get the Royal Guard out? They'll search for her.
Oh, no, can't do that. It'll just frighten her. Look, there must be some other way. I know. We'll hold a royal ball at the palace. Ooh. And then we'll invite every eligible girl in the kingdom to attend.
Every girl in the kingdom?
It's the only way I'll get to see her again.
Yeah, but every girl, even them two in this old max. What was she to say?
Even them. We don't want you without a date for the ball, do we?
Oh, you're too kind, Your Highness.
Oh, come on. Look, we've got to get back to the palace and write out all those invitations, and then you need to deliver them to every household in the land.
All right, Sam, how about this? I've got a better idea. We'll go back to the palace.
Yes.
And I'll invent email. How about that?
Whatever you say, Dandini. Whatever you say. As long as I get to meet her again. Whatever you say.
I'm sure you were wondering when I would next appear, but panto time for we fairies is the busiest time of year. I'm needed here, I'm wanted there. I really am so busy. All these people ask for help. It's enough to drive you dizzy. I met a man in green tights. Said his name was Robin Hood. I hope I was right to tell him that the babes were in the wood. When Dick Whittington called me up, he really needed me. Tommy the cat had kittens. Turns out he was a she. Then it was off to China to help Aladdin with his tail. I taught him how to fly at an allied carpet sale. I just got back in time to answer Snow White's call. She had a big problem. One dwarf was 6 foot tall. Puss in Boots had athlete's foot. He couldn't wear his shoes. Jack had green fly on his beanstalk. That's the end of the panto news. But at least you think our heroine is one that I forgot. Let me reassure you, I haven't lost the plot. For when Cinderella met her prince, I'm sure she found him charming. Though neither knows the other's name, which is a touch alarming. But when they meet at the ball, I'm sure all will be well. Though we'll have to watch out for those stepsisters from hell. They'll stop at nothing to ruin Cinder's chances. I know what girls get up to when they go to the dances. But despite them and their evil mother, Cinders will not be denied. She shall fulfill her destiny and become the prince's bride.
Well, paper's really falling away. I've hardly sold any files today.
And after Brexit, all the strawberry pickers have gone.
And now the sun, it's gone in. Who's going to buy my sunglasses?
Yeah, and Amazon have lost me pie order.
So what do you want to be, then?
If I was not a flower, girl, something else I'd like to be. If I was not a flower, girl, the painter I would be. Please hear me all day long, singing out this song. Splish, splash, splish, splash, slap it on the wall. Splish, splash, splish, splash, slap it on the wall.
If I did not sell strawberries, something else I'd like to be. If I did not sell strawberries, a crystal to run with me. You hear me all day long, singing out the song. Tickets, please, ring the bell. Any more room downstairs? Tickets, please, ring the bell. Any more room downstairs?
Splish, splash, splish, splash.
Any more room downstairs?
Splish, splash, splish, splash.
Any more room downstairs?
If I were not a pie seller, something else I'd like to be. If I were not a pie seller, a gopher I would be. You'd hear me all day long, singing out the song. Take a spoon, put it down, chip it on the green fork. Take a spoon, put it down, chip it on the green fork. Take a spoon, put it down, chip it on the green fork. Take a spoon, put it down, chip it on the green fork.
If I was not a plumber, something else I'd like to be. If I was not a plumber, a cleaner I would be. You'd hear me all day long, singing out this song. Dusting here, dusting there, dusting everywhere. Dusting here, dusting there, dusting everywhere.
Take your spoon, pull it down, chip it on the green floor. Take your spoon, pull it down, chip it on the green floor.
If I was not a servant girl, something else I'd like to be. If I was not a servant girl, a dancer I would be. You'd hear me all day long, singing out this song. Knees bent, arms stretch, then I do a turn. Knees bent, arms stretch, then I do a turn.
Take your space, ties down, chip it on the floor. Take your space, ties down, chip it on the floor.
If I was not a milkmaid, something else I'd rather be. If I was not a milkmaid, a goalkeeper I'd be. You'd hear me all day long, singing out this song. Catch the ball, pull it down, pick it up the field. Catch the ball, pull it down, pick it up the field.
Take your spoon, pull it down, tip it on the table. Take your spoon, pull it down, tip it on the table.
If I did not sell sunglasses, something else I'd like to be. Oh, if I did not sell sunglasses, a gardener I would be. You'd hear me all day long, singing out this song. Digging here, digging there, pulling up the weeds. Digging here, digging there, pulling up the weeds.
Take your spoon, pull it down, chip it up the table. Take your spoon, pull it down, chip it up the table. If I was not a son of girls, what else I'd like to be? If I was not a son of girls, a girl, girl, I would be. You'd hear me all day long, singing out my song. Take a small
Cinders. Still working? You do too much.
Oh, don't worry about me, Daddy. I'm fine. Oh,
you never complain, do you? Unlike your two sisters, who never stop.
Talking of those two, actually, I haven't seen or heard from either of them in quite a while. Perhaps they've gone to bed.
No, the last I heard, they said they were going on a training run.
A training run? Surely not.
Well, if they want to get run over by a train, Cinders, let them.
Physical. I want to get
physical. I had to go into physical. Oh, I do.
love a long, hot, sweaty session.
Oh.
And I hope the prince does too. How are you feeling, Mo? Can you hear your body talk, your body talk?
I can. It shouted, stop! Stop! Must be an easier way to lose weight than this.
Oh, there is, and I can help you with that. I can help you lose 7 pounds of ugly fat, just like that.
How?
I'll chop your head off.
I
didn't think you two were so interested in physical fitness.
Ooh, only since we met the prince, but it's worth getting into shape for, I can tell you.
What sort of shape did you have in mind?
How dare you? Mo here has a body of a 20-year-old.
In that case, she'd better give it back because it's getting all wrinkled.
Daddy, do you know what starts with come here and ends in ouch?
No, Mona.
Well, come here.
Oh, ouch.
Now you do.
Hey, get hurt by Daddy.
Oh, shut up, pizza face.
Oh, I think there's somebody at the door.
Oh, she's not as stupid as she looks.
She could be.
Well,
answer it.
Yes, my dears.
You shouldn't be so cruel to Cinderella. She's such a kind girl. And even you must admit she's very useful around the house.
You're so silly, thanks.
She's always running around after you two.
Exactly. What a lucky girl she is.
Oh, who was it, my dear?
It was a courtier from the Royal Palace. And he's brought us 4 invitations to the Royal Ball tonight.
I say, we haven't had an invitation to the Royal Palace for years. Oh. What a treat.
Well, this must be the prince's doing. I knew he fancied me.
It's your dreams, fish face.
Oh. No, see.
There are invitations for all of us. There's one for your mother and I, one for Mona Harder, one for Griselda Harder, and one for Cinderella.
Thank you, Daddy.
She doesn't need an invitation. She won't be going to the ball.
Leave her alone. If Cinders wants to go to the ball, she shall. Well, my dear?
Of course I'd like to go, thank you.
It doesn't matter what you'd like, you're not going.
No, she can't go dressed in those rags, so she doesn't need this invitation.
I said if she wants to go to the ball, she shall. And if you try and take that invitation away again, I shall get very cross.
We're terrified, aren't we, Mum?
I'm shaking my shoes.
I do actually have a point. I mean, I can't go dressed like this and I don't have anything else to wear.
Oh, well, in that case, I shall buy you a new dress.
What with? Our mummy's money.
You haven't got any of your own.
Not at the moment, no. But I'm prepared to make the ultimate sacrifice. I shall sell my medals.
Oh, no, you can't do that.
I can and I will.
Oh, don't touch the old things. You won't get much for them.
That shows how little you know. Some of these are very rare. This one's the Victoria Cross. This one's the Military Cross. And this one is the...
Charing Cross.
It's the George Cross. And they are very valuable.
Oh, are they now? Well, I don't think Mummy would be very pleased if you spend all the money on precious cinders.
You told Mummy that you didn't have any money at all. And if she finds out you've been lying, I wouldn't like to be in your shoes.
I think you'll find I'll be too small for you.
Good boy.
And anyway, how would your mother find out?
How indeed? Mummy! Mummy, come quickly!
Until the cows come home, or indeed until the gown comes home, because your mother's gone out, so she can't hear you. Come along, Cinders. I'm going to buy you the most beautiful dress in the world. Oh. You'll be the belle of the ball.
Thank you, Daddy. I can't wait.
Just wait, you
boys.
Goodbye, girls.
How
Henry Harder, where do you think you're going?
I was just going to take Cinders out. I was going to buy her a new dress.
Really? Well, when you get to the charity shop, why don't you just leave her there? Somebody might want a cheap, lazy little skivvy.
We've all been invited to the Royal Ball, Mummy.
And he was going to buy her a new dress.
Yes, he was going to sell his medals, Mummy, and spend it all on her.
And he wasn't going to give any to you, Mummy. Isn't he naughty?
Oh, yes, he is.
Well, I'll deal with you lot later. Henry, is this true?
Well, they are my medals, aren't they? And I thought I was entitled to dispose them as I thought fit.
Oh, but Henry, we are married now. And what's yours is mine. And what's mine is also mine. So I'm happy. And you can go to your room.
Oh, yes, but... all right, Mummy.
Henry! And when I say your room... From now on, I mean the attic.
Oh, no, not the attic. It's all dark and dusty and it's full of spiders.
And you won this for bravery. You're a wimp, Henry. Now go.
Yes, Hermione. I'm sorry, Cinders.
That's the way to do it.
Take my advice, girls.
Yes.
Men should be treated like a carpet. You need to walk all over them and beat them regularly. Now, off you go and get ready for the ball. I want my girls looking at their loveliest tonight.
We're going to the ball, Cinders, and you're not.
No.
Aren't we adorable?
We don't care.
No, we don't care.
I would still like to go to the ball, stepmother. Perhaps I could borrow a dress from a friend in the village.
It's out of the question.
But I was invited.
Really? Is that your invitation? Let me see.
No, you can't have it. It's mine.
Oh, Cinderella. I wasn't going to take your invitation because you... are going to tear it up right now.
Ouch!
If you think I have been cruel before, my girl, you've seen nothing yet. Now, tear it up. Get on with it, tear it up. Come along, quickly now. Smaller pieces, tiny, tiny pieces. There's a good girl. Now, get back to work. Look at the state of this place. There's litter everywhere. Don't you just love me?
Why does she hate me so? I've never given her reason to. If I'd gone to the ball, I would have seen Dandini again. But now I've lost the chance. Don't it feel like the wind is always howling? Don't it seem like there's never any light? Once a day, don't you want to throw the towel in? It's easier than putting up a fight. No one's there when your dreams at night get creepy. No one cares if you grow or if you shrink. No one dries when your eyes get wet and weepy. From all the crying, you would think this place is a sink.
Hi, kids! Hiya, Cinders! Are you all right?
I'm fine, Buttons, I'm fine.
What's all this?
Oh, it's my invitation to the Royal Ball.
Who tore it up?
I did. My stepmother made me.
Oh, never mind, Cinders. I'm really good at jigsaws. Yeah, I've just finished one that took me 18 months to do. I'm really proud of myself because on the box it said 2 to 4 years. Here, why don't you take this bit and go for 20 minutes?
Oh, there's no point, Buttons. I haven't got anything to wear anyway. But I did so want to go to the ball.
We can have our own ball right here in the kitchen.
How can we do that?
Well, first you need a glamorous gown. Yes, this is a creation by Jean-Paul Gottibeard.
Wow, thank you.
And next you need a gold... a necklace. This is a gold necklace there. There we are, madam.
Buttons, this isn't gold.
Yes, it is. It's 9 carats.
Yes, and now we need a tiriada.
What?
A tiriada. All princesses wear a tiriadas. There we are.
Buttons, you are silly.
And now I shall drive you to the palace. And there's a beautiful, beautiful, beautiful silver sleigh.
Wow.
Use your imagination, will you? Right. And now we need some fussy music. Very funny, Mr. Musical Director. I'm trying to cheer sinners up here. We need something exciting like, I don't know, dum dilly um dilly um dum dum dilly um dilly um dilly um dum dum. Right, here we are. Are you ready?
Yes, let's go. Thank you, Butter.
Yeah.
Dum dilly um dilly um dum dum.
We could have got Elton John, you know. Yes. We could replace you. Right, how about then? Let's try some sleigh music. Are you ready? Some sleigh music. Comfortable, ma'am?
Yes, thank you.
Yes, giddy up. Listen to the sound of the horse's hooves. Well, can you help us with some sound effects? Horse's hooves. Can you do... Oh, very good.
Wow.
Very good. And in the distance, you can hear the wolves howling. Very good. And the doves cooing. And the doves cooing, and the owls hooting, and the pigs snorting. Oh, I don't know how those pigs got in here. And then we arrive at the palace gates, and the huge crowd is waiting to cheer you, and escort you to the ballroom where the huge doors creak open. Oh, funny creak. And then the crowd see your beautiful dress. And the orchestra starts to play. And the man who really loves you is waiting to dance the night away with you. There's a lot you don't know about me, Cinders.
Well, I know you're very kind, but it's been quite a day. I think I'm going to go to bed now. Bye, Buttons.
Oh, would it help you if I told you I love you?
Oh, I love you too, Buttons.
No, I really love you.
And I really love you. You're my best friend.
No, you're not quite getting this. I love you. We could be married. I could look after you. We could have children. We could have lots of mini buttons, chocolate buttons.
Buttons, I don't like that.
You don't?
I'm sorry.
Well, in that case, I'm going to emigrate to Croydon.
Oh, no, don't do that, Buttons.
I will. I've done it before and I'll do it again. Oh, I was just trying to cheer you up. Oh, is that the time? I feel a bit of a, after all this excitement, got a bit of a headache coming on. I think I'll go to bed, Cinders. I've got the right up now.
Now I've upset Buttons. I can't seem to do anything right today. If I'd got to the ball, I would have seen Dandy again. I wonder who he's dancing with.
Can I come in, my dear?
Why, it's the old lady from the forest. Come in and warm yourself.
Oh, thank you, my dear.
What are you doing here?
Oh, I heard you needed some help. Something to do with a royal ball?
Ah, yes. Well, there was the royal ball tonight at the Royal Palace, and I did so want to go, but it was just a dream.
Nonsense. Everything is possible with me by your side, Cinderella. You shall go to the ball.
Who are you? I'm your fairy godmother. Don't worry, everybody has one. All the boys and girls out there do. It's just no one gets to meet their FG until they pass the test.
Well, what test is that?
Oh, I'll explain. Today in the woods, you helped an old lady. That was a kind thing to do. Now it's my turn to help you. I'm going to make sure you go to the ball.
How?
Well, we'll start by creating your fairy coach, but we'll involve a lot of fetching and carrying. Do you know anyone who could give us a hand?
Oh, well, Buttons could have helped, but he's just gone to bed.
Oh, well, he'll have to
to get up again then, won't he?
Buttons!
Hiya, Buttons!
Oh, where am I? Oh, I'm on Strictly Come Dancing 7!
Buttons, this is my fairy godmother!
Oh. I'm going to make sure Cinderella goes to the ball.
To the ball? Oh, Cinders, that's wonderful!
But we need your help.
Oh, we'll do, Hairy Gobstopper.
First of all, could you run into the garden and fetch me a pumpkin?
A pumpkin? Right, a pumpkin, I'll do that, yes.
Buttons?
Yes?
Make sure it's a big one.
A big pumpkin. Rightio!
I can't believe this is really happening.
It is, Cinderella. I'm going to make sure you have the most wonderful night of your life.
Will this do, Fairy Godmother?
That's excellent, Buttons. Just pop it up on the table.
Right. No, too heavy.
Stop making such a fuss, Buttons.
Wow, that sub fairy. Is she on steroids?
Now, next we're going to need two white mice.
Ooh, I have two pet mice in my room.
Well, off you pop then. Then, Buttons,
yes.
We're going to need a rat.
A rat? I'll get all the good jobs, don't I? I'll try the cellar.
Here be the pet mice, Fairy Godmother.
Oh, perfect. Just put those on the table. Now, you wouldn't have to have a lizard in your pocket, would you?
Oh, no, but there might be one by the well.
We only need one deer.
One deer? One deer? We've met nothing in a rat.
On the table,
oh, right. Okay.
I found a lizard, but he's a sleeping.
Oh, well, he'll just have to wake up again then, won't he?
Could you explain why we've got all these wild loving vegetables for Hairy Godstopper? Is it some sort of stew?
Don't be silly, Buttons. I'm going to make sure that Cinderella goes to the ball in style.
Huh?
So with one of my super spells, the pumpkin will become a coach. The white mice will be two white ponies.
Right.
The rat will be a coachman. And the lizard will be a handsome footman.
Now that's what I call magic!
But just getting a bit cramped for space here, Buttons. I'd like you to take everything out into the garden.
What, everything?
Yes, all of it, Buttons.
Right,
there,
okay.
Here you go. Now don't you worry about your ball gown, Cinderella. The fairies are already looking after that. And now for some real magic. All the boys and girls, I want you to close your eyes, cross your fingers, use your imagination and wish. Let me hear you say, I wish, I wish, I wish.
I wish, I wish, I wish.
Woven of the finest silk,
and sewn with silver thread. A coronet of garland, stars that glitter on your head. A necklace made of diamond, the brightest gem of all. You will be Princess Crystal, and you shall go to the ball.
How can I ever thank you, Fairy Godmother?
Your happiness is my reward. Now, listen very carefully. My fairy powers will only last until midnight, so you must leave the ball by 12 o'clock, for then your beautiful ball gown will become mere rags. Now, for one final touch of magic, before you meet your fate, close your eyes and believe, Cinderella, as your magic coach awaits. Remember, Cinderella, at the stroke of midnight.
Thank you, thank you. How lovely to see you all. You're all so kind.
Good evening, Baron. May I introduce Prince Charles?
Ah, good evening, Your Highness. My, haven't you grown? We haven't seen you for years.
I've been studying abroard, sir. How is life at Hardup Hall?
Oh, terrible, terrible. Rising damp, dry rot, subsidence.
Oh, dear, but what about yourself?
I was talking about myself.
My lords, ladies, and gentlemen, Baroness, my name, Harder.
Oh, dear.
Henry Harder!
Oh, that's my new wife, Your Highness. Oh,
my poor chap, I'm so sorry.
Oh, not half as sorry as I am.
Henry, why didn't you wait for me in the vestibule?
Well, your daughter's said that they wanted to make themselves look more lovely, and I thought that might take some time. I mean, oh, allow me to introduce His Royal Highness, Prince Charming.
Your Majesty, I'm honoured to meet you.
Ah, the honour's all mine, ma'am. How many daughters do you have, Baroness?
Oh, just the two.
And what
about... I can count, Henry.
Oh.
In fact, you've already met them.
Really?
Yes, at the Royal Hunt.
Uh-oh.
Mona and Griselda Harder? Surely you remember them.
Oh, indeed I do.
Yeah, they're hard to forget. Yes.
Oh, they did enjoy the hunt, Your Majesty. They're such sporty girls, aren't they, Henry?
Yeah, they certainly are. They certainly look like all-in wrestlers.
My lords, ladies and gentlemen, Mona and Griselda Harder.
Oh, you naughty boy!
How dare you! How dare you!
Oh, look at them! Aren't they amazing?
They're unbelievable.
I know they're dying to meet you again.
Well, until they do. Meet me again, that is. Dandini will entertain them.
Oh, but surely... Oh,
while I take you both for a glass of champagne.
Oh, you're so lovely.
Very decent, Charlie. I don't mind if I do.
Tidies from the beginning.
Oh, careful, you ugly great lummox. Told you not to wear those slingback wellies.
Well, once you were right, my feet are killing me.
I know quite a few people would like that job.
Yes. Oh, I say, see this young man over here?
Which one?
Yes, that one sitting right on the end. Okay. Yes. With the eyeliner, the pink jumper, and the tight white jeans.
I'd forget him if I...
Oh, no, I can't forget him. He was banging on my dressing room door all the way through the interval.
What did you do?
Well, eventually, I had to let him out.
Ladies! May I say you look very, interesting this evening.
Thank you, Your Highness. Tonight I am wearing my harpist girdle. Everything is safely gathered in. Turn many a man's head.
And a few stomachs as well.
Why, you?
Oh, hang on, ladies. Come on, not the time or place for a quarrel. Thing is, something I should probably tell you as well. I'm not actually the prince.
What?
You're not the prince?
No, I'm Dandini. I'm the prince's valet.
His what?
His valet.
Daddy!
Yes?
What's a valet?
Well, it's a sort of a dip between two hills, normally with a river running through it.
No, a prince's valet.
Oh, that's a sort of a manservant.
A manservant? Get off.
This is Prince Charming.
Oh, hey. Your Majesticals.
Your Royal Maleship.
Girls, you must say your grace.
For what we are about to receive, may the Lord make us true. Ladies.
Oh, well done, Your Highness. Not everybody spots that the first time.
As you know, these are my daughters.
I am Mona, but you can call me Moon.
and I'm Griselda. And you can call me anytime.
Both of them are available to you singularly or as a pair.
Oh, incredible. I really don't deserve them.
Who does? Piers Morgan?
What made you tell us that you were a servant?
And that little pipsqueak was the prince.
Just a joke, ladies. We just swapped places for a day.
I've been hoodwinked by hood.
And I've been bamboozled. My bam has never been so bamboozled.
Oh, no, look what you've done to Griselda. She's having one of her turns.
Oh, Majesty, I think you owe us an explanation. Oh,
I do apologise for the deception, ladies. Perhaps I can offer the whole family a little light refreshment.
Thank you. Henry, we can talk tactics.
Oh, if we must. I never have liked those little links. You see what I did there? Tactics, links.
Henry, I don't find you very funny.
No, you're not the only one.
Come on then, Griselda, let's go and grab some grub. I quite fancy a tongue sandwich.
Yeah. I couldn't eat anything that came out of a cow's mouth.
Yeah. Well, what are you going to have then?
A boiled egg.
Oh. That'd be adorable.
We poisoned your ice cream.
Well, well, well. What a gruesome twosome.
Oh, believe me, the mother's even worse.
There's no way.
My lords, ladies and gentlemen, pray silence for Her Royal Highness. It's the Princess Crystal!
Dantini, it's her!
Oh,
the girl I met in the forest. She's dressed differently, but it's definitely her, I swear.
No, Your Highness, that's no serving girl. It's the Princess Crystal.
It's her, I swear. Now go introduce me.
Don't manhandle me.
Princess! It is my pleasure to introduce to you His Royal Highness, Prince Charming.
You're the prince.
Indeed I am. Welcome to my palace.
Oh, why, thank you, Your Highness.
I get the feeling that we've met somewhere before.
Oh, I don't think I'd forget meeting a prince, sir.
Oh, well, then I'm so happy to see you, and I hope you enjoy the rest of your evening.
I can only stay for an hour.
Oh.
I must leave at midnight.
Really? Then I claim this dance and all your dances, Princess.
What's that you're drinking,
Bert? Oh, well, you've heard of Love on the Rocks. Yeah, this is a quick slog under the pier.
Well, it looks disgusting. Oi, Tiny, bring me your special.
Oh, what's your special, then?
Oh, it's the latest thing up at the Swan. It's a Guinness.
A Guinness?
Yes. G-U-I-N-N-E-S-S.
Oh, yes, Guinness. Oh, a sec.
Manners?
It wasn't me. Take that. Come away from the riffraff, Griselda.
Girls!
Yes.
Where's the prince? I was expecting him to be here to whisk you off your feet.
Whisk them off their feet? He'll need a forklift truck for that.
It's been the most perfect night of my life, the kind of night I've always dreamt of.
Oh, when you walked into the palace, you lit it up as if you belonged here. I could stay here forever.
Oh, it's been the best night of my life. You're a dream come true.
Oh, then, Princess, our dream shall be won.
It's midnight already.
Oh, who cares? The night is still young.
No, but I have to go.
Princess! Dantini!
Oh, excuse me, yes! Yes!
After her!
Oh, my man, sorry, to be married for 20
seconds! Oh, I see. Princess Crystal was in a bit of a hurry.
Well, perhaps I could catch a bus.
Probably got caught short, needed the loo.
Oh, no need to be so vulgar, Hermione.
You're lucky I said loo.
Excuse me, Mabel.
I'm sorry, Your Highness. There's no sign of her.
Oh, she can't have just vanished into thin air.
Look, the only person I saw out there was a servant girl dressed in rags, all right? Oh, but I did find this at the end of the terrace.
Oh, it's a crystal slipper. Oh. Dandini, I want you to search every household in the land. I swear by the stars above that whichever girl fits this crystal slipper shall be my bride.
It's day 47 in Arnott Hall. Buttons is in the corridor. Hiya, kids! This'll be useful in the future, trust me. Now, what I tell you. I wonder if Cinder's got to the ball. Did she? Oh, did she look really lovely? Did the prince fall in love with her? Oh, I bet she's really happy, isn't she?
Oh, Buttons!
Oh!
It all went wrong!
Oh, what happened? Oh. Where's your posh frock?
Well, everything vanished at midnight! And all I have left from the most perfect night of my life is this!
Oh, Cinders, that's beautiful!
Yes, but what use is one crystal slipper?
Well, you could put it on eBay. Long John Silver or Kevin Gauntlet might be interested.
You are silly.
Oh, sit down here and I'll make you a nice cup of tea.
Oh, that sounds lovely, but it's been quite a night. I'm going to go to bed. Good night, Buttons.
Oh, she kissed me. Oh, no, I'm still in with a chance here. I really am. Oh, hello, Baron.
Let me sit down. I'm completely knickered.
Don't you mean knackered?
No, I mean knickered. My breath is coming. In short pants.
What, you've been running or something?
Yeah. Hermione told me to run on ahead and make sure that Cinderella put a hot water bottle in her bed.
Oh, she's having an early night. She's gone.
Oh, well, I better go and do it then, otherwise Hermione will shout at her.
Oh, she's rotten to her. She really is rotten.
Oh, I know. I wish I could do more for Cinderella, Buttons.
So do I, Baron.
But Hermione knows just how to get round me. If I don't do exactly as she says, she threatens to pull out all my nose hair.
Oh, there must be some way we can get rid of her. And Les Dawson and Ian Sharples.
Get up at once. Let my darling little girl sit down. They're so delicate, aren't you, my darling?
Yes, Mummy, dearest. I totally pooped.
And I'm totally exhausted.
Why? We had to walk all the way back from Bourne. What happened to our carriage, Henry?
The hire company repossessed it.
So why didn't we get a taxi?
Apparently they haven't been invented yet.
But I did enjoy the walk home through the forest.
What? You must be mad. It was all dark.
And spooky.
We were scared.
Calm down, girls.
Calm down.
What was that?
That was a teat.
What?
A tea towel.
Buttons!
Yes?
I've just got one thing to say to you.
What's that?
Job centre.
Point taken.
We don't want to go upstairs on our own, Mummy.
No, not if this house is haunted, Mummy.
Oh, don't get upset, girls. There are no ghosts at Hardup Hall. Oh.
Except every year on the 14th of January.
That's today.
Is it? Oh, well, that's the day when he appears.
Who's he?
The Phantom of Hardup Hall.
The Phantom of Hardup Hall.
Henry, you've never mentioned the Phantom of Hardup Hall. Stop it.
But Buttons was only joking. I mean, apparently Buttons wasn't joking. There is indeed a Phantom of
What if Buttons is right, Mummy?
Well, there's a first time for everything.
Now, girls, don't be silly. There's no such thing as ghosts. Now, off you go to bed.
No. We want to stay down here, Mummy.
Not till Daddy's gone and checked that phantom thingy isn't in our bedroom.
Henry!
Yes.
You heard them? Come and check their rooms.
Oh, yes, my dear. Here, what's going on?
I'll come with you, Baron. That ghost is pretty scary.
Do you know what?
I think there is a ghost round here. And don't forget, I'm a medium.
If you're a medium, I'm a size zero.
Now, girls, I've already told you there's no such thing as ghosts.
Oh, what was that?
I don't know, but if you're scared...
We are.
Well, let's sing a song to keep those nasty ghosts away.
There's something strange in the neighbourhood. Who are you going to call? Ghostbusters! There's something weird in the neighbourhood. Who are you going to call? Ghostbusters!
What is that?
Ghost, come on that way.
Go that way. Well, we'll have to sing it again then, you're going to have to help us, you know. There's something strange in the neighbourhood.
We can call Ghostbusters.
There's something weird in the neighbourhood.
Who are you going to call?
There's
something strange in the neighborhood. Who are you going to call? Ghostbusters!
There's something weird in the neighborhood.
You go and have a look. You better be telling the truth.
Are you sure?
I can't see anything.
I think you're very naughty, noisy.
There's nothing there. What's the matter with you?
I'm very popular. Girl? So, do you go that way?
I'm still scared. Well,
we'll have to see it again then, won't we?
There's something strange in the neighborhood. Who are you going to call?
There's something weird. We don't look good. Think it, Paul.
Ghostbusters!
What's happening? What? What's going on?
Where'd you go?
Where'd you go? Did you take her that way? Well, we'll have to sing it again then, won't we? There's something strange in the neighborhood.
Who are you going to call?
There's something strange and it don't look good. Who are you going to call? Ghostbusters! What are you saying? What? What are you saying? I can't hear you. My other daughter's gone. Did the ghost take her?
Yeah.
Did we take her that way?
Yeah.
We took her that way? Are you sure?
Yeah.
Ooh. Well, we have to sing it again then, won't we? Ooh. Louder this time. There's something strange in the neighborhood. There's something weird and it don't look good. Who are you going to call? Ghostbusters. What is that? No, it isn't! It isn't! It's not! Right, well, I'm going to check then, and I'm going to have a look for this naughty ghost because I'm getting very angry now. Well, I can't see anything! There's no ghost here at all! Where is it? No! I can't really get that ghost now!
Hi, kids! I thought that ghost was pretty scary, but I'm not scared because I'm really brave.
How are you, mate? How are you doing? All right? Do you want to know who it is? I bet you do, don't you? I bet you don't know who it is.
Don't.
There we are!
Hello, everybody! Did I do all right, Buttons?
Oh, you were great. All that running about, you were ace. You really were.
Well, I'm a lot fitter than you realise. Oh, and that plan of yours really scared them.
Yes! I think you should have been an actor, Baron.
Oh, no, I haven't got the style.
I'm getting seriously worried about it, kid. Bye! Hiya, kids!
Hiya, kids! Oh, Buttons, I had such a wonderful time at the ball. I even danced with the prince.
Oh, I bet he's not as good as me.
Oh, yes, he is.
He may not dance as well as you, but he was so tall, charming and handsome. Imagine being married to a man like that.
Oh, no thanks, not my type.
But it doesn't matter, it was all just a fantasy and I'm sure I'll never see him again.
No, Cinderella, you've got to believe in yourself. Look at me, I don't want to be a handyman at hard up hall for the rest of my life, do I?
Oh, Buttons, I don't know what I'd do if you ever went away.
I'm not going anywhere. Hard up hall is my life. And besides that, you're here and I'd never leave you.
Open the door, open your heart, and every blood's somewhere to start. Just turn around, look what we found. Today's a brand new day. You gotta run with me now, I'll show you how. Come on with me, take a bow. Show them it's you, what you can do. Together we'll be okay. Rock on, Cinders, dance to the tune that this guitar sings. Rock on, Cinders, get up and spread your wings. Spread your wings, follow me into the sun. Come, we can smile at everyone. You gotta join in with me, and then we are free. It isn't hard to do. I said life is a song, so just sing along. And then another old bit can go wrong. Just you and me, come on and see. Together we'll be okay. Together we'll be okay. Together we'll be okay. Whoa. Okay.
Thank you.
Okay, here come the twin freaks again. Quick, let's get out of here.
Pretty and bright.
What a pity. Oh, I said, an awful ghost last night. It left me quivering in my boots.
Yes, well, you'd quiver standing still.
But you're looking even uglier with a fat
head. Oh.
Girls, this is no time to quarrel. The prince will soon be here. And whoever's foot fits that crystal slipper will be his bride. But first, we need to get rid of Cinderella.
Why, Mummy?
Oh, you know what she's like.
Well, how, Mummy?
Leave it to me. Oh, Cinderella. When have I ever let you down, girls?
Never, Mummy.
Oh,
Cinderella. The prince will soon be here, and you can't possibly meet him dressed like that. So I've sorted out a few of my girls' old clothes for you to try on.
Oh, that's so kind of you. Thank you very much.
Isn't it?
Has Mummy stopped taking her pills?
I think so.
Well, where are they?
Oh, they're in the cellar.
The cellar?
Oh, they keep much fresher down there.
Okay. So kind. Thank you very much.
My pleasure.
Do you think?
Here you go, Cinderella.
Yes, I do. So,
that's Cinderella safely in the cellar, and I've bolted the door so she can't get out.
Nice.
You're an evil witch, Mummy.
Yes, you're simply the worst. Well, Eddie dear, eat my shorts. Now, don't forget, don't tell anyone where she is.
Do you think we're stupid?
Don't push her luck, girl.
The prince's carriage has just arrived. How wonderful to have somebody of royal blood in our humble home.
Oh, Henry, you'll have to get used to royals popping in all the time when the prince becomes your son-in-law.
Oh. His Royal Highness, Prince Charming, and a little bloke of a cushion.
His Highness has declared that whomsoever this slipper fits shall be his bride. My daughters are here, sire, ready and willing.
Ah, what unusual names.
I meant they're ready to try on the slipper.
Yes, me first.
No, me first. Age before beauty. Thank you, sir. This is where all your dreams come true.
I think your nightmares are going to become a reality.
Well, I'm not going to stand here and watch your embarrassment.
Off you go, then. Is that tick, tick? What chance have we got? She can't get... Oh, right. Quick, put it on. That's it. Push. Push.
What are you doing, push. Fool man?
For this sake.
Push. It's no use. It's like trying to get a blue whale in a canoe.
Oh, I know what it is. It is my winter legging. Yes, I like to lag my legs. It gets cold in West Wickham, you know. Help me take it off. That's the one. Oh, that's it. Keep going. That's it. Nope. Oh, don't just sit there. Come on, put the shoe on. What's the matter with you? Put it on. Push. Push!
No, your foot's still too big.
Curses, rude words and bottoms.
Oh, never mind, Mona. Maybe your sister will have better luck.
No!
Make way for the prince's future bride. I shall now put my foot in the crystal slipper.
She wouldn't get her foot in the crystal palace.
Put that slipper on.
It fits.
Put the church order, the flowers. I want the full Monty for the hen night. It's on.
It's on.
Oh, enough of this charade. Do you have any other daughters, Baron?
No, he doesn't.
Yes, I do. Cinderella.
Oh, Cinderella. Yes. I'm afraid she ran away this morning.
She ran away?
Yes.
What is this trick?
Go on. Have you any idea why Cinder's in the cellar?
Absolutely none, Henry.
Last, my bride.
Oh, Your Highness. She hasn't tried the slipper on yet.
Oh, I don't think there's any doubt that it will fit, ma'am.
Oh, I'm sure you're right.
Oh dear.
I seem to have dropped it. It's an accident.
You did that deliberately.
Nonsense, Henry. It was an accident.
Oh, it doesn't matter anyway. Now that I've found Princess Crystal, we don't need the glass slipper.
Oh, Your Majesty, one moment. I do believe that you made a vow to marry whoever's foot fitted the crystal slipper. And as you know, a royal vow can never be broken.
What?
I'm afraid she's right, Your Highness.
No, you can't. That's your fault.
No.
Things are going awfully well. It's time to cast one final spell. The wedding will go ahead, no fears. Happily married for years and years. All Cinderella has to do is remember she's got the other shoe. But for them all to enjoy a peaceful life, I shall first have to deal with the Baron's wife. She bullies him because she knows she can. He's an officer and a gentleman. He'd deal with her so much better, I wager, if he acted more like a sergeant major.
Cinderella, I'm so sorry to ruin all your dreams.
Hey, quiet!
You horrible little woman! Silence in the ranks! I talk, you listen. Understood?
Yes, Henry.
Straighten up. Shoulders back. I think it's a spell of fatigue for you. You can start by scrubbing this whole house from top to bottom with your toothbrush. Right. By the left. Wait for it. Quick march! Left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left,
right.
What has happened to Father?
I think the worm has finally turned, but we still have the problem with the smashed slipper.
Oh, yeah. I've just remembered.
What? Then you've solved the problem. Allow me.
She won't get that.
No, don't think. No, it won't fit. Not at all. Nowhere near it. It fits!
Yes!
I think you've missed out on marrying the prince, girls.
Yeah!
We don't care, because we didn't fancy him anyway.
Yes. We've got our eyes on somebody else now.
Oh, come on, ladies, give us a break.
Oh, Dandy, did you play Tiddlywinks?
No, sorry, I play a terrible game.
Oh, well, let's go and play that one then.
I think we should be getting back to the palace, my darling. We've got so much to arrange.
But what about Buttons? Can he come too?
Well, of course. Well, Buttons, will you join us?
Well, no, Your Highness. I think I've, got a few jobs to do. I think I'll cut some confetti up ready for your wedding.
Dear Buttons, I'll miss you.
Oh, well, she's gone. But I loved her. No, I really loved her. She was my best friend. Thanks a lot. I was going to do a quarter of an hour then. Bang goes Oscar. Anyway, all that's time left for now is to sing a little song.
Good night, dear. And I've got just the song for us to sing.
Oh, it's just...
I like
it. It's
a lovely
song.
Oh, no, that's not fair.
You can read that, can't you?
No, they're going to sing my favourite song.
Right.
Yes, what? We can't sing that song.
Why?
We're going to sing my favourite. And I've got the words written down much larger than that. Are you ready? Well, I've got my words here. Look. So everybody can sing my words. Are you ready?
Yeah.
She'll be coming round the mountain when she comes.
When the saints go marching in, when the saints go marching in, I got nothing when the saints go marching in.
Not bad, but I like my song better.
Now, hang on a second, half this
lot. I'll tell you what we're doing. My half, you sing my song, yes, and that half, you sing their song.
Oh.
Are you ready, my side? It's as loud as you can. Are you ready?
She'll be coming round the
Coming round,
there he goes, my side. That was absolutely average.
We could do better than that, can't we?
Yeah.
Oh, no, you can't.
Oh, yes, we
can. Oh, no, you can't.
Oh, no, you can't.
Oh, well,
let's go.
I suppose. Come with
the same dreams, but what it is. The
not bad, not bad, very average.
Really? Right, should we have, I'll tell you what we'll do now.
What?
We'll sing both songs at the same time, that'd be great.
Your side will sing your song and
you,
our side
yes,
will sing ours.
At the same time.
Will you just
have to
concentrate? Are you ready? Let's go.
Oh, jolly good.
Yes.
Well, I think you better go and get ready for the wedding.
Oh, no, 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 no. We've been invited to a huge party at number 10.
Oh, no, we haven't, sister. No, it's not a party.
Not a party?
We're going to a meeting.
Oh, it's a meeting, apparently.
Are we going to a meeting?
Yes. Yes.
Right.
Yes. Okay. With drinks and nibbles and a
well,
disco.
Stay safe, won't you?
No.
Yeah. Stay up. Right, if we do it one more time, then, everybody, you can sing whatever you want to sing, really, as loud as you can. Yeah? Can we do it one more go?
Yeah.
Let's raise the roof. Here we go. Ready? One, two, three.
She'll be coming down the mountain. She'll be coming down the mountain when she comes. She'll be coming down the mountain. Coming down the mountain when she comes.
You have been absolutely fantastic tonight, but I have got to go and get ready for the wedding. I'll see you in about a minute. Bye, girls! Bye, boys! Bye!
We'll be right back.
sees me worse.
Great cheers to Cinderella and the Prince! Hip hip!
And so our story's over and it's time for us to go.
Thank you all for coming. We hope you like the show.
You came to our assistance when we were in a fix.
You're all the ones that stopped my dirty tricks.
We didn't get the Prince, but there are other joys.
Because we're off down the Legion for a night out with the boys.
Now that Cinderella is my wife, I'm such a lucky guy.
At last I can say those magic words, my husband and I.
And now we'd like to ask for one final cheer as we wish you
a very happy new year.
Thank you.